Okay, we're going to get a heads up for someone which is on the way, which is not empty.
And if you
and
could get
Samuel,
if you could check Samuel's got audio from
the shot, okay? He was able to pick it up alright, I just don't know where it's
You can recognize it.
Thank you.
Dave.
Hello. I'm Lily.
Hi Lily, I'm Hayes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Go and grab it.
If you don't know what table you're on, there is the mirror just in the doorway over there. For the ceremony itself, we are doing it in here and everyone can be seated. So maybe get yourself into a good position, see whether you can see up the front here or not. If you need to move your seat around or if you would prefer to stand, feel free to do so. A couple of housekeeping things from an evening flow perspective. What we're going to look at doing is the ceremony we'll be going through as one of the main reasons that we're here. Post the ceremony, we will all be filing out past all the bridal party and going outside for some photos on the lawn. During that time, we'll be calling for specific tables to come up and get a photo. So I'll be working with Tara, our lovely photographer, and yelling out for particular table numbers to come and have your photo with the lovely bride and groom. Then post that, I'll ask for everyone to come in and we'll go into the dance space just next door, and that's where we will be looking to do, we'll come in here first and we'll do cake cutting, and then we will head into the dance floor and we'll have some nibbles and we'll do some talking while Dave and Liane bugger off and go and get some photos taken. Post that, when they come back from doing the photos, we'll have a bit of a first dance happening in there as well, so we'll give you some notice for that one. And after that, we'll look to come in here, we'll do a couple of more housekeeping speeches, bits and pieces, not the full speeches, but just the little teasers out there for everyone. And then we will head into dinner and bits and pieces for tonight. We do have an opportunity for a couple of open mic speeches post the dance floor segment. So if you would like to say some words, please come and find me and let me know that you're interested so I can just kind of keep the flow going for us in between that, the cutting the cake and the dancing and us actually having dinner in here. But other than that, I will pass over to Steve and we will all get into position and ready for the big time to arrive.
It's still going. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
One short, full capacity. Little. All right, folks, just while you're doing that, if I can have a few words. My name's Steve Winter. I am privileged to be one of Liane and David's friends and celebrant for their wedding this afternoon, and I was very pleased to be asked to do that. I too have a couple of housekeeping things to deal with before Liane arrives. She knows that's happening, and so we'll just get that out of the way pretty quickly. The cutting of the cake will actually occur at the same time as we're signing the register straight after the wedding. After the celebration. So slightly out of the normal order, but that's how we're going to be doing it this afternoon. What I want us all to do now is just to take a moment and remember why we're here. So if you're worrying about what's happening at work next week, or you know what, you're having beef or fish later on, or what the band's going to be like, take all of those worries now and take an imaginary wee stroll out to the car park and put them in the boot. And come on back now and just think that we're all here because this
arrive want us to be.
That we're part of their lives and they're part of ours, and we're here to show them how much we care for them today. So put your love beam on high, point it up here, and give them the benefit of that. You can feel that from up here, I can tell you, from having done that a few times. So let's ramp the vibe up in the room and let these guys know how we think about them. Next, yeah. If you are the sort of person who's a bit tender about hearing people talk about their feelings, particularly the L one, and you sort of do a bit of that, you're in for a really awkward 30 to 40 minutes. So get with the vibe, let the whole thing flow, and if you're in a relationship or there's somebody that you care about that you've neglected or you haven't said so for a while, this might be a good day. Just, you know, nothing outrageous, just tap on the hand or a sly kiss to the cheek and tell people you care about them. Probably best you've met them or better yet know them. But today is all about a celebration of love. That's how these guys want it to be. And so let's respect their wishes. Now, I always think that there is no such thing as a free feed at a wedding, so you do some work in this ceremony that I do, and we're about to practice that bit. Now, I'm a patient man, and I've got nowhere else to go, and so we'll do this till we get it right. Generally, people get it right the first time, which is refreshing, and you look like a group that are probably going to be able to do that as well. So at some point in this ceremony, and you will hear me ask David and Liane whether they understand the promises that they're about to make, and they come to them freely. I will then ask you as a crowd this question, right? This is me, this is practice. Do each of you come here today in full support of this marriage? Do you pledge that support for David and Liane, not only for today, but for their future together? Now, surprisingly, the answer is we do. Now, if you're not of that ilk, then, and you are of the, if anybody here knows, department from the old wedding ceremony, really good moment to sort of slide out the side door. No. Good. Right. On three. Do each of you come here today in full support of this marriage? Do you pledge that support for David and Liane, not only for today, but for their future together?
We do.
One taker. Good work. All right, I think that's us. Let's enjoy ourselves. Let's relax. As I say, let's make this a ripper. Thank you. Don't panic, he's coming back. All right, take a seat, folks. Good afternoon, and welcome to a milestone day for David and Liane. You are here because they want to share this day with you. Each of you has touched their lives in a way that is important to them. With your help, they're about to make some memories that will last forever. We gather in times of uncertainty, Our planet is telling us that it's running out of patience with us. Loud voices seem to want to divide us. And in all of that, you might sometimes wonder, where do we look to for hope and optimism? Well, the answer to that question, ladies and gentlemen, is standing right in front of me and looking back at you as the day goes on. Wherever love goes, hope is very close behind. The power of love is infinite, and all it takes is our courage to unleash it. And David and Liane are here to unleash theirs into their future this afternoon. There are some words which will be read at virtually every wedding ceremony in New Zealand today that were written centuries ago. And they survive and remain as fresh as they are because they are simply true. And a guide to us for how our future can be positive, and the weapon we have, all of us, within us, against negativity and hatred. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not selfish. It is not easily angered. It keeps no records of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and is always ready to endure what comes. Love never fails. As I say, those words, as true now as they were all those hundreds of years ago. Whenever love's beacon is lit, its light can find the darkest corners of our soul and lift us off the floor. It makes us respect. It makes us apologize. It makes us forgive. It makes us all those things that are the best of us. It is the superpower that we all possess. It's the Jonah Lomu or Portia Woodman of our emotions. Give it the space, throw it the ball, and you don't really know what's going to happen, but you know that it's going to be pretty good. And that's what's happening here today. Love has the power to steer down adversity. Big love has the power to steer down big adversity. And combined love can turn adversity into a positive and meaningful relationship going long term. Congratulations, you guys, on being here today. Sometimes, love brings us to the point where we want to commit ourselves to somebody else totally, for good, to trust our very inner self to somebody else and know that they're going to look after it, grow it, and nurture it. Somebody we can trust with our very inner secrets and know they will be kept safe. That's the type of love we're celebrating here today. That is the love that David and Liane have for each other. I spoke to them this week about how they'd met, and I was actually part of their lives when their relationship began to develop into what it is now. But they told me about the slightly devious behaviour of Liane's daughter, Hannah, who would come home with her boss and say, "Why don't you come in for a coffee?" And Liane would be summoned downstairs, Hannah would disappear upstairs not to be seen again. So whatever that might lack in subtlety, it certainly makes up for an effectiveness, because from that grew this relationship and how it's grown through its various events to where we are today. And so we as a group are here to mark it with you and wish you all the best. Marriage isn't compulsory, we all know that, so I actually asked them also, why do you want to get married? What's the point of doing that when you already have most of what marriage can offer? And they said, no, we haven't. We have a love we want to celebrate. It's permanent. We want to shout about it. We want to tell our friends about it, and we want them to be there when we do that. They don't want to do this quietly. They want to seal their love and marriage in front of the people that are important to them and who they love. They want you to see and hear what they say and do today and to remember it and hopefully be inspired by it. Leanne and David can't tell the future any more than the rest of us, but they know one thing for sure. They know who they want beside them every step of the way as they walk into that future together. And so they are going to make that commitment by giving and receiving promises. Not the sort of promises I deal with Monday to Friday and some others in this room that have sunset clauses and out clauses and cash out clauses. These are the real deal promises. They're permanent. They're binding. They're not to be entered into lightly. They are serious promises of commitment, one to the other, permanently. They are the foundations of their future together. And so I now ask you both, Lawrence David Mercer, do you understand the promises that you are about to make? Do you come to them honestly and free of any obligation to any other person?
Yes, I do.
Leanne Cherie Rowe, do you understand the promises you're about to make? Do you make them honestly and do you come to them free of obligation to any other person?
I do.
Family and friends, we want to mark this day and spend it with Leanne and David. More than that, we are here to say that we support them beyond today and we hope they will do the same for us as their lives go forward. Do each of you come here today in full support of this marriage? Do you pledge that support for David and Leanne, not only for today, but for their future together?
We do.
So that's the end of what we might call the preamble. David and Leanne are coming to an end of a chapter in their lives, which is ending positively, and moving into a new chapter in a few moments as husband and wife. When you come to a milestone like that, they want, and it's a good idea, to look back to where you've been, to remember people who contributed to who you are and how you came to be here today. Each day as we tread life's road, we tread the flagstones left to us by people who went before. We learn from their mistakes, we absorb their values, and in a significant part, we take them forward with us. Our forebears are with us here today in that sense. They are part of it. They are in this room celebrating this marriage with the rest of us. Some of you will have no difficulty at all in feeling that presence. For others, simply acknowledge that our past is important to us. So to the makers of those memories, we say thank you. And reflect on what you have offered our lives as we look back at what you've done for us. Leanne wanted me to mention her mum, Josephine Sutherland, Alan Sutherland, and Faye Nesbitt. David wanted to mention his father, Colin Mercer, as people that they would both have loved to be here today, sharing in their love and happiness. And so let's take a moment to think back, all of us, on the important people in our lives who cannot be here with us, but whose contribution is such that we would not be here had they not made it. And so I now say to the makers of those memories, go now from this place. Go with our respect and our love. And go to your place where you watch over us, with our respect and enduring thanks. Kina mate o te whānau nei haere, haere, haere. He apiti hono, he tātai hono. Te hunga mate ki te hunga mate. He apiti hono, he tātai hono. Te hunga ora ki te hunga ora. Haumie, huie, taitie. My apologies for any mispronunciation in amongst that. David and Liane wanted Te Reo to be part of today, and it has been. I'm asking now, please, Diane Harker to come forward as she has a reading for us.
I don't believe in love at first sight. I believe in love at first debate, first argument, first inside joke, first genuine laughter after a lifetime of sadness. I believe in love at first heartfelt conversation, first completely comfortable, unawkward silence. I believe in love at first support through hardships, first shared pain and first divided joy. I don't believe in falling in love with a face. I believe in falling in love with a mind and a soul.
Thank you, Diane.
We're just making some arrangements here, folks, for something to be retrieved from a car.
We're still going ahead. It's all good.
Can somebody get the keys for that car, please?
No, it's not the ring.
All right, we'll just solve the mystery. It's the vowels, all right? So it's reasonably important.
Just slightly.
So I think we might, if everybody's okay, just wait till they're secured, because it's Leanne's wedding ceremony. Let's have her relaxed, shall we?
See why you're so tense.
Yes.
And you were right. I was crying.
I know. You owe me 10 bucks.
It was fine to turn around.
Top job, that man.
This is novel, I haven't done this before. Anyway. So from that fairly interesting end of a chapter to a life to the beginning of a new one. Leanne and David, we wish you moments of great joy and achievement in your future together. And we expect that that will happen. But remember also that marriage sometimes can be hard work, and you will need to work on that together. You are now a partnership, an equal partnership, and with your combined talents, the sky is truly the limit. But experience tells all of us in a marriage that you will test each other. We hope not, but you may find yourself asking each other and yourselves some hard questions. If that happens, bring yourself back to this point, this time, this place, in front of these people. Because the answer to those questions, Leanne and David, is literally looking you in the eye, right now. Take a moment to remember when you first met, how the person in front of you became more and more important to you as time passed. As you looked into the future, a shady figure had begun to creep into the edge of the photo.
And as time moved on, they moved into the middle and solidified to the point where you didn't want to see that picture without them in it. The point that you knew you had found the mythical one, that your heart had found its forever home. And how you wanted so much to come here today and to say that to each other and to other people. Think about all those things that make you want to marry this person today. Soak all of that up. Stow it away somewhere safe in your memory. And if and when you need it, come back to how you are feeling right now. And remember the moment when every part of you wanted nothing else but to repeat after me. I, David.
Take you, Liane.
To be my wife.
I promise to love and cherish you.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
For richer, for poorer. For better or for worse.
I will forsake all others and remain faithful to you.
From this day forward, I choose to be your husband.
Your best friend and only love.
To live together.
Play together.
And laugh together.
To work by your side.
And dream in your arms.
And definitely dream in your arms.
Fill your heart and feed your soul. To always seek out the best in you.
Always loving you with all my heart.
Until the end of our forever.
I promise to love and cherish you.
In sickness and in health.
For richer or poorer.
For better or worse. I will forsake all others and remain faithful to you. From this day forward.
I choose to be your wife.
Best friend and only love.
Live together, play together, and laugh together.
To work by your side.
And dream in your arms.
To fill your heart.
And feed your soul.
To always seek out the best in you.
Always loving you with all of my heart.
Till the end of our forever.
Thank you.
We'll do on hold hands. Actually, you're going to have to read these. Right. David and Liane have both prepared personal vows, as we are now plainly aware. And I'm now going to ask David to make these promises that he has written to Liane. And I'll ask for the ring at this point. And so David will place that ring on Leanne's finger at the conclusion of his vows.
Should be interesting. Excuse me, one second.
Now these words have been written right up until the last minute, literally. My dearest Liane, the These following words are put together by me, however, are heavily plagiarized from other wordsmiths greater than I. One song in particular I've used for recreation. And I will break it down as I go along. This may be long, and I make no apologies for that, as these emotions, as there are emotions that need to be expressed, words needing to be released from in here. And I find that hard to do. So in front of friends, family, and God, we will see a miracle, a mere male expressing his feelings with words, backed up by love. I have to let everybody know with words how much I love and care for you, how great my feelings for you are. From our humble beginnings, through our courtship by trial and fire, to my vindication, which became our victory, a battle hard fought with tremendous output of work done by you. I believe I stand here today because of two people, and you, my love, are one of those two people. I can honestly say, with no bias, that no one else has ever loved me as you do. There are no words great enough to describe what and how you do what you do. You are a tremendously beautiful, sensual, styling, and elegant woman. With an iron-made backbone, strong and flexible. In the beginning, I thought you were well out of my league. Light years, in fact. Mates have even commented before today that I've punched above my weight bracket. In the beginning, as was described to me, if you looked into my eyes at an unguarded moment, you saw a dead soul walking, a soul so utterly ruptured, gutted and bleeding, it made you cry just getting a glimpse of that, and it made me cry to hear that description, mainly because it was so true. Inside, I was a dead man walking. You shone your love onto me, to our song. This is what you had to deal with, words I have yet to vocalize. I keep fighting the voices in my head that say I am not enough. Every lie they said, that I would never measure up. You sensed it, felt it from me. I never let you know in words how greatly I was wounded mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. I was almost a finished man. In my world, I had lost all that was precious to me, to my girls. Then your love literally saved me. In my darkest hour, your God-given gift of love and your face floated before my eyes. Moments before I would have put my foot on the car accelerator and left the decision up to fate. Your love came shining through. I still to this day marvel at the depth, power, and unselfishness of your love. And remind me once again who I am, a question you answered every day. You said, I am yours. You told me every day that I was loved when I couldn't feel a thing. My faith in you made me say I believe. in your love because you've never lied to me. In times of doubt, you said I was strong. Just when I felt I was falling way short, you lifted me up, you helped me keep strong. Your loving tenderness kept me up. And the biggest break and the biggest breakthrough for me was when I thought I didn't belong. And you looked me in the eyes and you said, I am yours. You are mine. And at that moment I believed. Yep, I believed. There were days and there were nights that I clung to it. As your love, bit by bit, hug by hug, kiss by kiss, tear by tear, put me back together, and I became all yours. You came to me as a package deal. And finally understand what Meatloaf was talking about when he sang, you've given me a child with my body at all. Well, you have. Today I am almost yours and almost a stepdad. As you and Hannah know and feel till now, and I haven't verbalised it, for I have lost my girls for the time being. They still are my world, but locked away in here until the day I may hug them again. Know this. You are not here to replace them. You are here because I love you for who you are. I wish to love, honour and fiercely protect you both. Unconditionally. Protect and love you both unconditionally. Independent and together. Hannah, whenever you need me, I'll be there. You just have to ask. Your friends will be my friends. Your loved one will be honoured by me. And your enemies, well, that goes without saying, doesn't it? I'll kill them. Sorry. Sorry, no lawyers here, are there? To the present, in front of everyone. I have tried to tell you, in words, which is not my strong point, how much I care, admire, and love you back. In so many ways and for so many reasons, my life is about to be reborn. I will love you for all the rest of my days, as you so richly deserve. You are the one. It's that simple. In closing, and from this simple farm boy, I am yours forever, and a day after that as well.
My darling man, David.
Mm-hmm.
soul, yeah. It's fine. Anyway, I don't apologise for this. Yeah. I stand before you today after being after a long journey that we have arrived together today. I believe that God has brought us together for such a time as this. You are to me the love I have always wanted, but never dreamed was more to have. You draw me out from my place of quiet shadows, and you shone your sunshine on all the beauty I didn't know was there at the time. I could not fully see it. I often say, thank you for loving me, and you reply all the time, it's not hard to love you. People say sometimes, oh, she or he is my better half. I say, we are two strong individuals as two wholes joining together as one formidable team. You, darling man, have added many things to my life I never dreamed possible, even on this day, our wedding day, and all the days ever after, to the death do we part. I promise today, before our friends, loved ones and family, including those watching via the net, I, Liane, will love you, really love you, how you should have been loved, I, Liane, will love you, really love you, how you so deserve to be loved, honoured and respected. My soul and everything I have is completely yours. Joined together with God, we are a united team, an equal partnership. David, I know that whatever we face, past, present, now, and in the future, I know 100% that we have each other's back. You have proven yourself to be worthy of my whole life and trust, my love, honour, and my respect. I have seen you face head-on, near impossible challenges, some you faced on your own, and some we face together with me by your side. I love your tenacious spirit, your courage to never give up, and especially when life becomes hard. David, you have a lion's heart, a character full of strength to always love and protect all that you hold dear. Pity the fool that ever comes between that bond. Whatever has been behind us, those past love stories, for that time, then are closed. They will always be part of us. So today, we close those doors with respect and open another to our greatest adventure ahead. So watch this space. To my dearest daughter, Hannah, I thank you for introducing me to David, for allowing me to love again and being there to support us in our journey together. David and I are very proud of the beautiful young lady that you are and what you will be in the future. Finally, and I mean finally, before Chatty Cathy hijacks the wedding, and for those who know me well will appreciate the meaning of that, Chatty. Anyway. Okay. Some of your friends have said, some of your friends and our friends have said to you, and I quote, cool, you're punching above your weight there, aren't you, Boyle? Funny you put that in your mouth. Well, I thought this also. I mean, I thought I was also punching the same. Turns out I have a pretty good, pretty mean right hook. Ask Roger and Nick Simons as my gym coaches and support crew. You two, as in Roger and Nick, are awesome. Thank you. And you're part of a big reason to why I got here. And I'm honoured and respect and thank you for your part in this. In summary, you are my forever person, my darling man, and a fine specimen you are. how blessed am I?
David and Liane have, in the most personal way, told us how they feel about each other and why we are here to... Liane, come on.
Sorry.
Why we are here today. Some of you now understand more why it is a privilege for me to be here. And to mark that they have exchanged promises. They've exchanged rings as a symbol of their eternal love. And it is now my privilege to pronounce them husband and wife. Across to the room, corner of the room, sign the register, and then there will be the formal cutting of the cake, which you may wish to stay for and watch, of course, and then the festivities can begin. Thank you for listening. I'm sure that you felt what I felt and that you both felt that as well. Thank you very much. All right.
Three, one, two, three. And one more. Okay, I'll just get a handful of the headphones.
Did you want a picture of my hands?
lovely.
Just one more down side.
Okay, and I'm just going to get you to lean right around, put your arms around them and give them a big hug.
It's so lovely.
Oh, nice. Yeah. One more. Okay, on three. One. Big hug. One, two, three. And on the last signing, I'll get you to look up at me and smile.
Stand on either side of
it. Oh, that sounds great. I'll get one of them on his own and I'll get you to do that, yeah. Okay, they want to stand either side of you.
All good.
around him and give him a big group hug. No.
Beauty.
It's lovely.
Documents are signed, there is no going back, and it's now my very real privilege to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Mercer.
Yeah,
All right, folks, wasn't that a lovely ceremony? A little bit unorthodox, but that's what life is all about, isn't it? So what we'll look at doing now is we'll all head outside as well. No doubt there'll be a few kisses and hugs to go through. Greg, you said you were happy to do kisses and hugs with anyone who needed them, so feel free to see Greg for that. And we'll look at being outside and doing some photos before returning back in and heading into the dance floor to do some of the nibbles and bits and pieces.
Training.
Welcome to the family, my man.
Hello.
That's all right, I'm just looking around.
Yep. Oh, bridal party in the front row. I need you to move along.
Table three will be out there. Everyone can start to make the moves inside, but I'll be calling you table at a time.